How many people here have heard about novations? Okay, they're very popular with you got to mute yourself if you got background noise, please. You got novations legally are just a replacement of a person in the contract. Okay, and they're very popular with the gurus of the week club right now. And in fact, if you're on my Zoom room, there is a wonderful 38-minute YouTube video that I posted in the Zoom chat room. You've got to listen to it. It's fantastic. They really dissect the novation and what it is. And basically, it's going to somebody and saying, I want to buy your house, but I'm going to find somebody else. I'm going to list it on the MLS. I'm going to do the repairs, and then I'm going to list it in the MLS and resell it. You need special paperwork, power of attorney, special contracts. It's complicated, it's time consuming, and there's more ways for it to fall apart compared to using an option or another type of sales strategy. So a novation is just a replacement of the people within a contract. When you go to somebody and you say, hey, I don't want to buy it anymore, but Vic the K wants to buy it now. So we're going to change the contract with your permission. And you do this in advance. It sounds to me, and please, somebody can disagree with me, but it just sounds very time consuming and costly. And I think it opens up the door to litigation. So, but that's my two cents. Feel free to disagree with me.
Well, don't people do novations a lot of times if they're trying to fix up the property and they don't want to take title to it, basically?
But if you're going to fix up someone else's property, why don't you just buy it? Yeah. Or why don't you just option it first? Wouldn't that be the easier way?
Well, I guess if you optioned it, I don't know. I guess I'm thinking an novation, you have a... I don't know, more of a chance that you won't lose your money. I don't know.
Listen, have you listened to that recording I posted in the Zoom room?
I need to watch it.
It's not as opinionated as your uncle here. It's real. They really dissected the pros and the cons of it. And it's two fellas, and they know what they're talking about on it. It's the flavor of the month for the guru. Why do gurus have a new strategy all the time? They always have a new strategy of the week or the month or the year. Why do they always come up with new ideas and strategies? What's going on in their head? Reverse engineer it, please.
They want to make more money.
Keep it fresh.
How do they make more money?
They sell a new program.
Yeah. Thank you, Rick. I'm sorry. Am I being too obvious? Okay. To me, KISS method all the time. Keep it simple. Even if you have a sales agreement or an option agreement with an assignment clause, the ability to sublet, transfer, or convey your rights to a third party, and you record it and you bind it with some consideration, you're in much safer legal ground than you will be doing something that's manipulating the system. I always think, what's going to happen if there's a problem and someone gets ticked off and you got to go to the judge? What's the judge? The judge is going to look at the intent of the transaction. And the judge is going to say, hey, you never really intended to buy this property or anything. You're just setting this thing up to manipulate the system. That's what I think they're just going to look at it very simply like that. And guess what happens to your deal and all those thousands of dollars of repairs you did in that house? So I hope that this is subjective, guys. This is my opinion. Feel free to disagree with me. I don't have the last answer or word on everything. But I look at real estate as, what's the easiest, simplest, most legal way I can do the deal and protect myself? That's the way. And what's the profitability of the deal? And can I be totally upfront?